Hey, what's up everybody? It's Meredith Shirk with Svelte Training, and right now I have a full body standing belly fat workout. We're gonna work the love handles, working the lower abs, upper abs, and probably your butt too. So if you're into that and you want to get your butt working and your abs working, let's do this. We're outside and we're gonna do the windmill. So chest up, shoulders back, feet a little bit wider than shoulder width, hands facing down. As they come up, they're opening up. As they come down, they're closing down. So you're gonna go both directions. We're just starting here first for 15 seconds. Really feel like you're pushing all the way up and through and reach, and then come all the way back down. Go ahead and switch sides. Really reach up and over. You wanna feel like you're connecting your obliques, which is your side of your core, all the way down to your toe when you reach, reach, reach. Good. Keep going. Now reverse the other way. Get a couple more. I like to switch it up. Up and over. And that's your windmill. All right, now we've got knee drivers. So when we're doing knee drivers, we're having one foot that's a little bit elevated. So I'm on a little bit of a rock mound in the middle of this yard here, but you can use a small bench, a stair, wherever you just have your foot a little bit elevated. So you start almost like a lunge position and you're driving off the right leg to stand. So a really small motion, but you're driving almost like you're running, getting ready to sprint. Something like a sprinter start. So in 15 seconds, each side driving off the heel to get really into that glute. So as you step back, stabilize, and if you're not ready, stay for a second. Really drive up off the leg. Change after 15 seconds. About two more. Really push off this foot here, drive up, and now change. So from here, get yourself situated, because you don't want to start when you're not ready, right? So down, and you're pushing off, right? If you need to, because this is my left, so you can see I'm a little bit different. If this is for you too, just drag your toe a little bit. Drag your toe and stabilize yourself, because everybody's got different limitations. Let's go three more. Three, two, and last one. Big step. One, drive it up. Really feel it in the back of your hamstring and your butt. So take your time with these variations with the knee drivers, because the most important thing is that you're getting the drive in your butt and you're actually doing the movement, not speeding through it. So those are your knee drivers. All right, we are ready for the torso twist. So same positioning as always, we start from the ground up, feet nice and planted, chest up, shoulders back. What you're doing is twisting your torso, but there's a couple different ways that you can end. You can look at me twisting, or you can look towards your arm. When you're looking towards your arm, you get a little bit more twist in the opposite oblique. When you're looking towards me, you're forcing yourself to stabilize on that, on the oblique that's actually coming towards you. Good, really twist. Should be pulling all of that air out. Good, go five more seconds. Four, really twist. Three, two, last one. Hold it and then untwist. Big breath, feel your rib cage open up. Let it ground down. That's your torso twist. All right, I thought it was fitting enough that we're outside that we should do wood choppers. So a wood chopper is, I'm on an angle, which is nice, a little bit of a hill. If you have a step to step on with an off foot, that's great. So a staggered stance, as if you're holding an axe, you're coming up over your core, over your knee. So you wanna end up where your elbow's over your knee on the side. So you're really crunching down. So we're going 15 seconds on this side, and then I'm gonna cue you for 15 seconds on the next side. Really feel like you're extending your obliques and then crunching down, but also then extending from your back. Really using your body as like a tool to move in one unit rather than disjointed. Good switch legs. What I mean by disjointed is my arms are not attached to my leg, right? Through my torso. So when my arms move, my legs and my torso are also moving. But if you're not conscious of it, it's not gonna give you anything good. Just extra movement. Good, 3, 2, 1, instead of flexing and actually getting all of your body to work in just a short amount of time. So those are your wood choppers. Now we're up for crisscross crunches. So it's in a cross body crunch standing, which is nice. So your elbow on your right side is gonna meet your left knee when you come up this way. So we're going 30 seconds, and I want you to think about crunching and extending. So everything is about the extension and then the flexion of that muscle. So you can put it more time under tension, really squeezing in the core, then you're gonna get a lot more out of these workouts. Good, really pull into the stomach, pull into the core, knee to your elbow, chest up, breathing nice and even. Really push into that core as you reach for the elbow. 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Crisscross crunches.
And that was it, everybody.
We'll see you guys on the next one. If you liked it and you love it, I want to hear from you. So click below, make sure you comment, like it, love it, share it. I'll see you guys on the next one.